Right, so let's unbox this brand new camera then. This is the old camera that I've been using for nearly 7 years. It was bought in the Black Friday sale of 2013. And after being dropped hundreds of times, the automatic shutters no longer work because I think I spilt something in it. That jammed it up. The covering here is gone because we've been dropped. It survived drowning in water, which nearly did actually end its run, but managed to save it. It's finally... Oh no, well, I'm going to show you something. It still actually fully works. But I'll show you the problem. So we've got our SD card slot here. We've got our SD card. Yeah, it doesn't click in anymore, so I can't record anything. It won't go in that way, because it's the wrong way. Of course. So that's annoying. Anyway, enough of that one. So this is the old HDR CX410 VE. It has a gyroscopic lens. So as for anyone who wants to know what I was always recording with, that's what's been recording for the last 6 years. But the thing is, it automatically came on standard recording. It wasn't in full HD when I was first using it. So for a long time, it was recording like 480p or something. Anyway, I thought I'd get a camera and upgrade at the same time. Because of course we're now in a 4K digital age, so I'm going to have a 4K camera. Unfortunately, at the present moment in time, I haven't got a 4K movie suite, so unfortunately when it comes to editing 4K, actually my laptop might be possible to do it on, but my current computer setup can only still do it full HD. Anyway, that's like next year's project, and then we will be recording certain things in 4K. But anyway, anyone actually wanting to watch like the unboxing of this actual camera, you can watch now. So there's a thing down below. Anyway, it's the Sony FDR AX43. It retails at around £600, although trying to get your hands on one during this. And by the way, we're not in lockdown because it's like August, late August, but the stock for these cameras isn't really back in stock until September. I managed to get hold of this brand new from Currys. It was the last one. Anyway, so we have our Sony seal tab, but the thing is, this seal tab's a bit rubbish because I've already opened it and it already looks like it's already sealed again. Although saying that, how it was packaged, it just literally came in a sealed bag and that was it. No actual protection at all. Don't know who to blame there. Right, so we'll remove this tab like so and undo it, and ta-da! Yeah, you see, the thing is, when I actually got this, it was rattling, but as it turns out, it's just the instructions, which is a good thing. Then we lift that open like that, fold that over, and yeah, so this is what we've got inside. So we have our our mains charge lead with a 3-amp fuse in it. We have a HDMI cable, so you can play stuff to your TV or something. We have obviously the transformer, which hasn't changed at all. So I can use this on any of the Sony cameras, including my old one. This one I'm using as well, which is also a Sony. And then we've got the battery. Now it's a much larger battery than what you'd get as standard. This is the upper battery size, so it's a 1900 milliamp hours battery. Just in comparison, this is the larger Duracell equivalent that you can actually buy in shops. And if you notice, it's even larger than that. So this one is 1640 milliamp hours battery, but that's a larger battery than what came originally with my camcorders, all of these, including the one I'm actually recording on. So just to give you an idea, this should run for around 4 hours, because this runs for about 3.5, and if you have the small battery that normally comes with it, you get about 2. So that's quite impressive, you get a 4-hour battery. Typically speaking, they also cost, I think the Duracell versions are around £40. I think this is £25 for this size, and you can get the small ones for £15. So I think the actual genuine Sony ones are like £80-90. Anyway, but that Duracell will fit that as well. So, as well as the brand new camera. So yeah. And there it is! So, just for the size comparison, I thought that was big. And just for size comparison, yeah. So, when you see that photo, you can see how much bigger they are. Anyway, we'll take the battery, and then we're going to put this in. So get it in, you have to push this tab down first to get it in, which is quite annoying actually, because this you could flick in without it. See, I didn't have to push that down to get that in. So I'm not too fond of that, but I suppose it's a better holding since the actual tab is over the actual battery. And yeah, they've even like all this. This is how it's actually designed. Look at that as well. Right, so we'll take a look at the side here. It's really, look at the size of that thing. It's also really heavy. So anyway, we've got a strap, but we don't have a USB, because we now got a HDMI instead. But the strap's still pretty much the same for holding, like so. Down here in the corner, we've got a headphone jack. On the old model I've got, it's actually inside a door. On top, we've got our 5.1 channel surround mic. We have a 5.1 surround on the old one, but I can't actually see it anywhere. Oh, it's there at the front. We've also got a little red light here when it's switched on. And I think it works with a remote as well. Underneath, we've got the screw to hold onto a tripod base. Other than that, so look, and then on top, there's no difference, but we've got the wide and tight zoom lens, as well as the button for the photo. So everything's already set up, but when you first turn this on, you'll have to select your language. Set the time and date, for example. But the one thing that hasn't changed is how much battery. Now, I did that for like 10 minutes and the battery was still flashing low the entire time. So, I'm guessing this battery needs a good charge. Still, I've been playing around inside the menu and having a look. So, we've got shooting mode. So we can obviously have a movie, we can take a photo, we can take a time-lapse capture, slow motion record, or a golf shot. And down there, there's one more, it needs to be in certain mode to do it. And that is high-speed recording. Right. So your camera and mic is all the settings preset, including like exposure and shutter speed. But the thing we are, we've got a wireless. So you can control with the smartphone. That I've got to try out at some point. Then we've got multi-camera control. Operate the smartphone to scan the QR code or imaging Edge Mobile. But not bothering that. Right, so, right, menu. And then you've got image. Now this is where you've got several options. So at the minute we've preset it to how we normally have it on the old camera. So this should give me around, let's say, in battery low. So what I'm going to do, let's actually, so what we do with this is we've undone our two parts, and then this is your standard T-prong, which you can find on many electricals. Plug that in there, we'll plug that end into the plug socket. We're going to plug this end into the camera. So we'll go into here. Oh, where is it? Right, so your HDMI is in here and plug in power. The mic, you can have microphone. So the power for this is actually at the back here. Yeah, it's a little like flip down thing, which is kind of neat, but I'm going to guess it's going to snap off at some point with me using it. Anyway, actually that's quite good, doing this and having that flap. Having that flap actually serves quite a good purpose, so it saves it from bending down too much. The problem I have with both this camera I'm using and the other camera is that the charge cables are wearing out on them, because they're steadily basically breaking here, just due to bending. Anyway, neatly, we've got a power on off button here. Not that bad. Right, what we're going to do is I'm going to put this SD card in. Oh, that also reminds me, it's here. And it just flips across like so. You can have an SD or you can have a micro SD, I think. We'll put our standard SD in. Right, and it should tell us that we can get 10 hours 29 minutes in this particular mode, which is correct. There's about 80-90 gig left on this memory card. So you get 10 hours with AVHD better quality. Hang on, so right. So, with AVHD high quality. So, but we'll reset it to, we don't want that. I'm going to select file format, and we're going to select 4K. And we can get precisely 3 hours and 7 minutes of 4K recording at 25p. At 60 megabits per second. We can also record in 100 megabits per second, but we can't take stills at this point. We can also take, if we lower the frame rate, I'm pretty sure we can record in, so yeah, it's 4K and up to 25 frames. Dual video recording is something new on this, so you can record in 4K and record in the very, very low format so you can publish very quickly to things like social media. So if you're wanting to record, I probably wouldn't use it as much, but there are times which I could probably use it. So this will allow you to record a very small movie at the same time that you can upload very quickly to things like Facebook, Instagram, etc., and other social media sites. Right. We've also got image size. Image size determines the still size megapixel rate. We can have up to 16.6 megabits. Anyway, for file format, then we've got XAVCSHD. This will be 1080. This allows more. It's got backlight detection, so it's obviously compensating for it. Our frame rate is at 50p, or we can set it down to 25p. HD will still record in 1080p, so. And then finally, we'll go to AVHD. Now, this is the only one I had on my old camera, was AVHD. So, it will preset to high quality, which is around 720p, with 50i preset as well. We can have 50p and 25p. I'm just going to look how much memory. So, there's no real difference between I and P. Oh, wait, I set that, didn't I? So when you select 750p, it's not as. It's for some reason. Is preset like that. 50p and 50i. 50i, you can record more on 50i than 50p. But I think I'll be starting to record now more in 50p rather than 50, than 50i, and maybe even 25p. I'm going to try it out. But while we're at it, so in 50p, you can't use any other image quality size. There we go. With AVHD, you can. So we can have even things like standard, which is around 480p, and long time, which is about 240. If I select long time, we've got 23 hours, need 24 hours. That's twice as much as the 720. And if I go into highest quality, which also, now I wonder. Now, this might be able to prevent. Let's have a quick look. Yeah, so when we record in highest quality, we can't take pictures. That's the same as the old camera. And we've got around 8 hours instead of 11. So we've got lots of different recording modes and quality modes. I'll do a special video, I suppose, at some point with some colourful towels on the washing machine to see how well it captures it and how well it kind of looks at some point. And obviously got setup, including like formatting the SD card, repairing image database. That will automatically happen if it's me recording and power is lost to it. When you plug it back in, it will recover the image, and it will recover it 99 times out of 10, 99 times out of 100. Or at least that's what the old one did anyway. We can also do edit and copy and stuff like that, including like protect the files, highlight and stuff. But I don't obviously do this on this because I've got my computer to do all that. And then obviously camera and microphone. including things like, which are all set to auto. Hopefully this should record better in this kind of light, because this light is proving, this new light I've got is proving problems for at least this camera. Interesting. Right. So that's the unboxing of my brand new camera. Wants to see how we get on with it. Alright, thanks for watching. I'll see you soon. Look. Yeah, so when we record in highest quality, we can't take pictures.